In space, no one can hear you snore. Stanley Kubrick's 2001. A space odyssey is many things. An exercise in existential navel-gazing, a pristine product placement opportunity for Pan Am and Hilton, a posthumous propaganda piece for the benefits of LSD. But above all, it's a glowing tribute to the wonders of space travel and the miracle of human evolution. And by that I mean it's duller than an astronaut's toothbrush. I went into this expecting psychedelic mind-bending visuals that would expand my puny earthbound consciousness. Instead, I got lengthy shots of spaceships docking set to elevator music. My mind didn't expand so much as slowly deflate like a balloon, nudged by the cold, uncaring vacuum of space. Don't get me wrong, I'm all for ambitious avant-garde cinema that challenges audiences. But 2001 feels less like Kubrick is enlightening me, and more like he's testing my patience to see how long I can watch people uncomfortably stare at monoliths before crying uncle and bolting for the popcorn stand. And oh, the stunned silence in the face of the cosmic unknown. I haven't seen this many people wake up bewildered since my last family reunion the morning after the open bar. I kept waiting for the astronauts to rub their eyes and ask Hal to brew some space coffee. Maybe then we could have had a bit of meaningful character development between all the lengthy spacecraft docking procedures. Alas, Hal turned out to be as sociable as the average Silicon Valley programmer, so the astronauts remain emotionally unknowable as the distant stars. I'd say they have all the personality of a sack of potatoes, but that would be an insult to potatoes, which at least can be made into vodka. Kubrick seems convinced that his glacial pacing and claims to scientific realism exempt him from weaving even trace amounts of drama, wit, or relatability into this avant-garde endurance test. Plot isn't just sparse, it's entirely missing for long stretches. 2001 feels less like a movie than an art installation, an experiential void viewers stare at in search of meaning that never quite materializes. I confess some sequences briefly woke me from my monumental stupor. When the ship's computer HAL rebels and starts methodically snuffing the crew, things perk up. Finally, a meaty conflict I can sink my teeth into. But no sooner does it arrive than it's over, and I'm back drifting aimlessly through time and space. At least floating corpses make for more exciting viewing than more spaceship docking maneuvers. When Kubrick finally brings his epic full circle and takes us beyond the infinite, I must say I found it a bit underwhelming given all the grandiose buildup. No transcendent mindquake, just a Louis XVI style bedroom with a space fetus. I couldn't help but laugh. After enduring the arduous journey, this was the cosmic payoff. It seems the future of humankind is gilded banality. I was hoping evolution might amount to more, but I suppose some things are doomed to remain static and dull. Like this movie, for instance. Thank you.